This is your first challenge. One thing you'll notice today is that you'll have to use your imagination a little bit. If you think about everything you're talking about this week, a lot of it is based on how do you create an effective team? How do you get everybody on board the same mission and work together effectively? Well, what I want you to think about right now is this circle representing the bounds of a team. Inside this circle is effective teamwork. This is the optimal team that you could create. This is where you want to be, is inside this circle. Right now you're standing on the outside. You're having a meeting talking about what are our best practices, how can we do that, but you're looking in, saying how can we create that team. So your goal, ultimately, is to get everybody into this circle. That's your ultimate goal, is to get all 13 of you into this circle. Now if you look inside this circle, first of all, the circle is set. You cannot change the size or the dimensions of it. So you cannot move the rope. That is set. If you notice inside the circle, all the ground where I'm standing right now, the ground represents everything that can get in your way. All of the mistakes you can make, the miscalculations, not dealing with people in the best way. So the bottom line is nobody wants to touch the ground where I am. Luckily, you have some resources, these boxes. You can think of these boxes as, in some ways, each other. But these are the resources you have to rely on, the systems you have in place, the people you can rely on, the skills that you bring to the team. So these boxes are what you can use to support you as a team. Which means you're fine on top of them, but if anybody steps down, that has consequences. I'll talk about that in just a second. One other thing about these boxes. These boxes, these resources, like most resources, are flexible, but not infinitely flexible. Which means you can reposition them in the circle, but only one time. If you pick up a box, once you put it back down in the circle, you've committed to that location. So each box can only be repositioned in the circle one time. Everybody got that? Each box can only be repositioned one time. Also, be careful. If you slide a box, it's stuck. So you want to pick them up if you move them. Now, as far as consequences, if anybody touches the ground, if you've noticed back at work, whenever you make a mistake, it impacts the people around you. Which means if somebody steps on the ground, you can think of it as a breach of integrity almost. But if you touch the ground, it impacts everybody in the group. The consequences are, if someone touches the ground, anyone else in the circle has to exit. And then you can come back in. So you lose the time it takes to regroup. So if anybody touches the ground, everyone has to exit, and then you can re-enter. Your goal, in the next 12 minutes, you're too good of a group, 11 minutes. Your goal in the next 11 minutes is to get your entire team into this circle at one time, balanced on top of these resources for a count of 5. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. These are the only resources you have. Each box can only be repositioned in the circle one time. If anybody touches the ground, everyone has to exit and then they can re-enter. The time does not reset, nor do the boxes reset. Does anybody have any questions?
We can touch the ground to go in and move the box.
Absolutely not.
No.
The ground cannot be touched at any time.
You gotta get inside the box.
That's like saying, right, if they're not watching, I can do anything. Any other questions?
So where are you going to leave them there in the center?
That's where I'm leaving. Your 11 minutes begins now.
Could have come over on that one. You can get here.